little bit differently tonight and go with a group toast. You see, we formed a bit of a ragtag family of friends here in Boston, and like any family, we all want our say. I've known Erica for the least amount of time of the five of us, but in the last 3.5 years or so, Erica's become a fixture in my life. We share many of the same interests in literature, television, and movies, and can often be found raiding each other's libraries or having a quiet night in, with Lisa, of course. At a time in my life when I really needed a friend, Erica was right there to help me through it in her own quiet and supportive way. With an open door and a steady stream of Buffy the Vampire Slayer DVDs and gummy frogs, that period solidified our friendship just as tonight solidifies Erica and Lisa's future together. Thank you so much for the opportunity to preside over your wedding. I love you both.
I'll never forget the night Erica broke the news that she was going to propose to Lisa. We were driving around after a trying adventure, having one of those universal conversations a friend shared a thousand times over. During a pause in our dialogue, Erica simply announced, "Dude, I'm going to do it." I immediately knew what it was. No further explanation required. Erica's next statement sealed her intention and expressed the happiness she shares with Lisa. She turned to me and said, "My life started the day she walked into it."
There are two reasons that Erica and I became fast friends when we first met. One was that we both are from Worcester and apparently battled each other on the basketball courts of Notre Dame and Doherty High for years without even knowing it. The other was because the night we first hung out, I drove her home to Somerville, and two of her friends shared a first kiss in my back seat, which made for a pretty long and awkward, yet very memorable drive home. Erica and I have been through a lot together. I remember many a fun night hanging out on Gorham Street, and somehow sleeping on a cramped love seat, and making it to work the next morning. And I'll never forget the blizzard weekend when a half a dozen of us were stuck at Erica's house for 3 days. As some of you know, Erica and I lived together for almost 2 years, and our friendship stood this ultimate test. Me, the OCD roommate, and Erica, the ever more social of the two of us, came out of that apartment having stayed out the better for it. Erica, I stand here before you and among all of our best friends. And in Lisa, I know you have found not only your best friend, but your soulmate. Lisa, I've never seen Erica happier than when she is with you. And I know I can speak for everyone here when I say that I wish you both all the happiness in the world as you begin this new chapter of your lives.
Erica and I have been friends for a number of years now, and the first time we met, I clearly remember thinking, who is this crazy girl who doesn't know what light bulb she needs? Only to find out later that she was thinking that I was the crazy girl who didn't know what light bulbs to give. I have many wonderful memories of time spent with Erica, the coming of age days at Gorham Street, the constant trouble that we caused at Bay State Ave, sorry Kate, trips to buy large items at Home Depot and Kermit, our dear friend Roger. I will cherish all of them forever. I would have never thought that midday run in Porter Square would turn into this, and that I would be standing here watching you marry your best friend, the love of your life and companion. I love you both very much. You're both very special, remarkable people, and I can't wait for you to have babies.
Well, I never. She said as she sternly walked across the room away from me. And that's how the first conversation I ever had with Erica ended. Needless to say, we've gotten past that first encounter, and I now stand before you in possibly the greatest of ironies to talk about how thankful I am for those endeavors. You see, without Erica, I never would have imagined how stubborn yet compromising a person can be. Without Erica, I never would have been able to believe that from the ruins of a first conversation like ours, I would gain a lifelong friend that I consider to be family. Most importantly, without Erica, I never could have imagined seeing someone as happy and as complete as Lisa Schmader. From the moment you guys met, I could tell you were home. May your lives blessed be together, and here's to long, happy lives filled with, well, I nevers. Here's to the brides.